Patients get diagnosed in many different ways. There's not one path through which a diagnosis occurs. Ultimately, something abnormal is either felt or identified on some kind of an imaging test, so an ultrasound or a chest x-ray or a CAT scan. And to make a diagnosis of cancer, you need pathology, you need tissue, and that requires a biopsy.
I went in for just my standard annual physical checkup. And as part of that process, the prostate is checked out and it was enlarged. And so that raised the alarm bells. And so we went, sent off to the hospital and had samples taken. And that determined that there was cancer there, so we proceeded from there.
We use staging, it's somewhat historical, and it does have some meaning when we look at statistics in terms of what the overall survival is, what we call the disease-free survival, so how successful treatment is. Usually we look at the five-year mark, and the higher the stage in general, the less likely that we're going to have a cure if we're looking for cure, and the overall prognosis or overall survival tends to be lower with more advanced stage disease. It's really more about the behavior and the biology of the disease that helps us estimate or guesstimate what the risk of recurrence is and how aggressive one needs to be in terms of treating a particular type of cancer. Treatment is quite variable and is determined in part by the type of cancer that a patient has and the stage of the cancer. So there's generally a number of different modalities that we use in treating cancer. There's surgery, where surgery is indicated to remove a primary tumor. There may be a role for chemotherapy, which are medications that we give often intravenously, but sometimes in the form of a pill that may shrink the existing tumor. It may be used to prevent the cancer from coming back. There's radiation treatment, which is often used to prevent the cancer from recurring, although it is used in the setting of advanced cancer to treat specific symptoms.
I had about 5 weeks of radiation, and at the same time, I was taking chemotherapy tablets. So that was the first step in my treatment. Following that, I came back to North York General, and I had surgery on May 7th. That was difficult, just getting over that, because I had, major surgery. But following that, I started chemotherapy in June for 8 sessions, and that was completed in October of 2012.
There is a group of hormonal therapies that we use in some cancers, particularly in breast cancer and prostate cancer.
The hormone treatment is, a big ugly needle they stick in your abdomen. And it's a little uncomfortable, but it's not bad. That was every 3 months, I think I went down for that. And for 3 or 4 of those treatments, and that was extremely effective, brought it back down to 0. So we just kept monitoring the PSA count. And we still are.
Really the question is, what is the goal of treatment? Is it an early stage cancer, in which case chemotherapy is being used to prevent the cancer from coming back, similarly with radiation to prevent the cancer from coming back. Patients may get treated every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks, every 4 weeks, and they may get 4 months of treatment or 6 months of treatment. Depending on the type of cancer, it would depend on the pathology and the characteristics of the cancer that determine which regimen, which group of drugs we use for a particular cancer. And that also will determine the frequency of the treatment. The outcomes really depend on what your starting point is. If you start off with a disease that's incurable, then those patients are deemed palliative just because they're incurable. But they may live for many years, and they may live for many years with good quality of life. For patients who have earlier stage disease, stage 1, stage 2, and in some cancer stage 3 disease, the goal of treatment is cure. And so one is hopeful that with whatever modalities are felt to be indicated, that patients will become disease-free and the cancer will not reoccur. Patients who've completed their treatment need some form of follow-up. The follow-up and the type of surveillance that is indicated will be determined by the type of cancer they have. At a certain point, that surveillance may stop for the original cancer, but patients should continue to see their family physician, to have annual health checkups. If they are concerned about new symptoms, they need to bring that to the attention of their physicians.
I have a mammogram every year, and then I also have an MRI every year, but alternating 6 months. I see my oncologist still once a year. I don't see my family doctor with any extra regularity. I was seeing the surgeon, also trying to do that every 6 months so that I space it out with my oncologist. Do I think about it coming back? Sometimes, only because I have so much more of my life ahead of me. I was really young. I don't think of it as a blessing. I don't think of it as anything, really. It was just something that happened, and I just continue living.